Hello, welcome back to Elise Reads and Speaks. Today I'm excited because I'm bringing you my TBR for the Reindeer Readathon. I participated in this readathon last year for its first year. It was the first readathon I've ever participated in, and I had so much fun. I met so many fun people, and I just can't wait to do that again this year and see who I'll meet this year. So last year I was on Team Nutcracker. Sadly, I'm not on that team anymore. This year it is all about Team Snowflake. We want Team Snowflake to win. All right, so I'll go through each of the prompts, tell you what I'm reading for each, and hopefully this will inspire you to also join the readathon. So I'll put Eric's video down below from Break Even Books. It has all the information as far as like filling out the Google form for submitting your books, also filling out a Google form that will sort you into different teams so that they keep it even and fair, you know, all that good stuff. Okay, so to kick it off, we are starting with Dasher. Read a book with a one-word title. So I chose Pet by Akwesi Amenzi. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that name right. I'm very sorry if I'm not. I chose Pet because it is my book club's pick for December. We actually had two books chosen for December. One was Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes, or Snakes and Songbirds, and we pretty much already read that, all of us, almost all of us, and we all kind of like were middle of the road on it, so we wanted something else that maybe will end the year on a good note. So hopefully Pet is that book. The next prompt is Dancer. Choose a companion novel or a sequel. All right. I'm choosing a middle grade. It's probably younger than middle grade. If you remember, I read The Time Traveling Fashionista on board the Titanic, and then it was young for me, so I sent it to a friend's daughter. I happened to find the next two in a thrift store by me, or like a secondhand bookstore by me, and I was like, all right, I gotta snatch these up. I'll read them, and then I'll send them along to my friend's daughter. I'd like them to get there before Christmas, so I'm gonna put these into my December reads. This one is about Marie Antoinette, all right? So she must go back in this magical dress that brings her back to that time. Sounds lovely. The next prompt is Prancer, read a book with a map in it. Oh my gosh, I have so many books with maps, but like finding a book on my shelf that I hadn't read yet that has a map, it was tough. So I am going with The Jewel by Amy Ewing. Now, full disclosure, I read this book years ago. Don't remember much about it. Don't remember much about the second one. Then I never got to the third, so I need to start from the beginning. And there is a map right in the beginning of that book. Not your typical map, but hey, it is a map of the Lone City. Has the word map? It is a map, okay? It's a map. From what I remember from this series, like these girls are chosen as surrogates for the center city because the people with magic in the center city can't make their own babies or something like that. Like, it was really bizarre, but at the same time, it like got me into it. So I'm looking forward to starting this series off and finishing it. The next prompt is Vixen, where you could choose to read a book with a fox on the cover, or for slightly less points, you could read a book with a strong female character. So I went for the strong female character because I don't have any books with foxes on the cover. Like, I mean, I must have some somewhere. I can't find one. So the book that I'm going with is an arc that I have to read for December. It's called Escaping Eleven. It's by Jerry Chisholm. I don't know much about it, but it seems like kind of like a dystopia kind of, or futuristic, whatever, but it seems like she needs to like battle to survive. All right, to me, she must be a strong female character. I'll let you know. The next prompt is Comet. Read a book that you find intimidating. So I'm going for The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang, and I want to read it physically. I read the, I listened to the audiobook months ago, loved it. I've also listened to Dragon Republic. But before I go into The Burning God, I really want to read the first two physically before I go into that last one. And The Poppy War is big. Like, The Poppy War is over 500 pages. So that's also going to go with the Christmas Star bonus. Christmas Star, you can pair it with any prompt. The Christmas Star bonus is just read a book that's over 500 pages. So I'm going to use that one for Comet and Christmas Star. The next prompt is Cupid. Read a book from a genre you love. So I went through my arcs that I have to read for December, and there's one that sounds super cute. It like involves fairy tales and godmothers and a little romance, but it's also modern. Like, it seems like a mashup of things that I enjoy. It's called Fairy Godmothers Inc. It's by Serena de Wilde. And I guess the premise is that this girl has to either get back with or like fake marry this guy that she used to date to please her fairy godmothers and bring them to this holiday resort. I don't know. It's like a mashup of like the good tropes in romantic comedies and then also a little splash of magic in there. Sounds lovely. The next prompt is Donner, read a book with something hidden inside. So I told you that I gotta read these next two so that I can send them to my friend so she can give them to her daughter. But look, I'm just gonna randomly flip to a page that's got something really cool. It's got this beautiful artwork throughout of all these different dresses. And I took off the cover of the book just to see what was underneath. And I thought that was really neat too. Like they all have a different color. I think the other one is pink, so maybe the first one's purple. I don't know. But these books have got some gems hidden inside them. The next prompt is Blitzen, read a book with some type of struggle. So I went through my December arcs again. These are books that I have to read before the release dates in December. And I am going with We Thought We Knew You by M. William Phelps. So this is like a true crime, true story kind of book. You have to figure out who done it and he uses all this evidence. I don't know if we'll find out at the end who did it, but I feel like that's kind of the struggle, figuring out who actually killed this woman. And the last of the reindeer prompts is Rudolph, read a book with some sort of misfit character. So I'm going with Fairchild. It's by Holly Meisner. This is another arc that I have for the month of December. And it's about this girl that kind of like looked into a lake and then this other guy brought her through and then she's the only human in Fae territory. I love me some Fae books. I love fairies. And she's totally gonna be a misfit because she's the only human there. So there are two bonus prompts. One I already told you about, that's the Christmas Star bonus. You have to read a book that's over 500 pages. The other bonus is the Slayin' It bonus. If you get through all of the prompts, then you can go back and redo a prompt to get more points for your team. I think you can only do this once. So I have two picked out. I like to give myself options. So if I get that far and I wanna go back and do one of the prompts, I have two options. So I could do the Dasher prompt, which is to read a book with one word in the title. And I have the arc for Lore by Alexandra Bracken. And you know me, I love me some Greek mythology. It's just, I'm really looking forward to that one. I think that one releases sometime in January or February, not totally sure. Or I could choose to go back to the Dancer prompt, which is to choose a companion or a sequel. So I already told you for this readathon that I am reading The Jewel by Amy Ewing, and I have the next one up on deck, which is The White Rose. This is the sequel to The Jewel. So we'll just see. We'll see if I get through all those prompts. We'll just see if I feel like reading Lore or White Rose. I don't know. Oh, I almost forgot to mention the buddy read. So this one won't count towards any of the prompts, but it's just a buddy read if you want to take part and talk about this book with other people throughout the month. And it is The Secret Life of Addie LaRue. That's by Victoria Schwab or V.E. Schwab, whichever you prefer to call her. And I'm really looking forward to this one. So I'm hoping I can partake, but the prompts are going to come first because those are where you get the points. Okay, so those are all the prompts. Go Team Snowflake. I'm very excited. I love team readathons. I don't know. I think it's just the competitive nature in me. I really like to win, or at least try to win. When I'm doing a readathon by myself and just, you know, getting points and it doesn't count for anything, I'm like, nah, okay. But this, if I can beat other people, it's just very exciting for me. All right. Thank you for tuning in to Elise Reads and Speaks. I will catch you next time, guys. Bye.